Hello everyone. How much freedom has your imagination? Do you feel any boundaries in your minds? Or would you agree with me that the sky is the limit? I would like to talk today about one of the greatest achievements of humankind. It's not any monument, a machine, or a masterpiece. It is the process of innovation. The process that gave us everything we use today, from pencils to democracy and vaccinations. The process occurs constantly. People invent new things by repeating certain activities, by applying solutions from one field in other areas, or by conducting purposeful scientific research. The process resembles the process of evolution. The existing ideas are being replicated by other people, whereas the creativity plays a role of a mutation that creates new species. Then the inventions have to compete among each other on the free market. And the best ones are selected by the societies that play the role of natural selectors based on the appeal and the utility of the innovations. There is a difference, however. Whereas genes and their mutations are completely random, the process of innovation can be enhanced. You can work to encourage yourself to be more creative, to create better ideas. You can also use different tools and frameworks to enhance your creativity or polish existing solutions. For example, brainwriting or brainstorming. Unfortunately, there is no algorithm for the successful innovation. In a similar way, like there is no formula to calculate the next prime number. However, by studying existing innovations, we can recognize certain patterns that can help us, inspire us to new solutions. A famous futurist, Joel Barker, has coined a term, innovation at the verge, that refers to innovation that combines two ideas from different, sometimes even contradictory areas. An example can be gift wrapping paper and paper bags. It took people over 40 years to put these two components together. A more spectacular example can be vertical farming that combines skyscrapers and food production. In effect, it saves place and decreases the cost of food transportation. Another recognizable pattern is frugal innovation. Frugal innovation satisfies basic needs of people by replacing the existing products and services at the fraction of their original cost. Frugal innovation usually starts in the developing world, but then it often spreads to the rich countries. A good example may be microfinance services that help poor entrepreneurs to obtain cheap loans. Another example can be mobile services in poor countries where farmers and merchandisers can check prices online, can do payments, and even post job offers. We can't think that innovation happens only in distant realms, that it requires a laboratory full of machines or an engineering degree. Robots are spectacular examples, but they are built by armies of people, out of whom majority may be even not creative. Creativity is about attitude, not aptitude. Think about a pencil. It's one of the simplest objects on your desk. However, it is the effect of many innovations. First, triangular or hexagonal shape that prevents it from rolling, a rubber eraser at the end, and the rubber dots at the sides that help to grab it firmly. Innovation has a lot in common with art. Art has inspired many innovations, whereas innovation has led to many artworks. Both require openness and harmony. There are workshops organized that help to create new ideas through music and painting. Art lets us to break the mold and free our minds from the limiting mindsets. By trying to interpret a concert, we can take ourselves through a brainstorming session with ourselves. Artists and innovators have a lot in common. They have to practice a lot. You would never create a successful innovation unless you rehearse yourself constantly. Even if you think that you have your great idea, you have to repeat it over and over again, just to make sure that you feel the tone of it, like an artist. Great artists were also great innovators. Music and art give you the freedom of expression that can be hardly found anywhere else. Mozart has not only written great music and great concerts, he has also invented new kinds and styles of music. I encourage you to think about innovation in a new, different way. In a way where you become an artist and you look for new ideas to fill the white canvas.